The Browns got a new stadium. They're in a dome now? All right. Who knew? Rocking the throwbacks. Crapola, as my mother says. Oh, hello. My name's Miles Murphy, dog. Bring the heat. Complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Come on. Look how small these numbers are. Damn it. We rocking the old 60 uniforms this game for both teams. Actually, I think mine's 70s and theirs are 60s, but it's okay. Who is this tight end? Ah! There we go! Go ahead, TJ. Yes, sir. Okay. Oh, good play. Atlanta 4-0, baby. Matt Corral dogging out over here. Miles Murphy. Take it. I'll take it.
A great play there. Every game could be called a measuring stick game, but I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I agree with that totally because division games have a little extra to them. But this game is situated because at this stage of the season, it has a little extra juice, but at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16, somewhere in that neighborhood.
Watson, off play action. He's going to drop this one down for Chubb. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45. This defense for the Steelers, they were terrific in the win over Tennessee a week ago.
How'd you like to be the quarterback reviewing the game tape from last week and seeing this defense?
Damn.
Almost every snap, but the ball was in the air, they took it away.
There we go.
Just as he let that go. And now it's third down.
Here's play number seven on the drive. This is third and seven. Now it's Watson. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. Very important third down conversion right there, because when you're trailing and find yourself this deep in enemy territory, the kicker's not even part of your thought process. You got to make it pay off with six. Nice connection right there to set up first and goal.
And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. Faking the give. Now Watson. Now he'll escape to his right. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down. Watson.
There we go. Just stop.
Now what do you do here? Well, to me, at this stage, after this drive, this close to the goal line, 3 points would be a letdown. I'm going for it here.
And this kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing in 7-3.
From what you did before, because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters, because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Going right side here, and that's complete. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
Well, they obviously red man covers their partner, and he got downfield, broke down the defender, made him think. Yeah, he made him think he was going to run a different route. Probably thought he was going to take it upfield, and it curls back inside for the completion.
So they'll get 8 out of that completion, and it'll be second down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space.
Money. Wow. Jameson's going off this year.
That they want to insist on going in that direction, make sure you've got your best people in the area to try and take that away.
Now this throw caught left side.
Damn.
And he's taken down and able to swing across the 35.
Barney sold the go route really well. Thought he was going deep. They called him back inside for a nice completion.
DBs love when they pump the brakes, don't they?
Yeah, that's really a whole lot of fun. It's almost like you said, listen, if you're going to sell the go, just go and let's see who's faster. To win any route, you've got to break down the defender, and that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl.
Watson looks to throw again. Complete to Stewart right side. Second and a yard. Now Watson. Flushed out right. He's got the first down here inside the 30.
Oh, man.
Football. You're getting better athleticism,
Great hand-eye coordination. Guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Oh, wow.
Not what you wanted there. It goes as a sack and a loss of a yard. And not only that, now it's fourth and goal.
Ah, I had it. Damn it. I haven't even ran with Najee yet. I just outran him. Money in the bank.
Relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now a first down carry for Harris. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run pass option.
You get the sense? The next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And he finds a man on a crossing line. They're all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. A big play that time on the catch and run.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw.
He's out of bounds.
The way he's been slinging in the first half, you expect everything he throws to go for a touchdown. But I guess he's got the way to try to pick up that third, isn't it?
I thought he had for a second, but you're right, not to be.
Oh, you should have caught that. Oh, wow. Damn. Wow.
First and 10 at the 14-yard line. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. And a nice little game. 4 yards rushing for him now to this point.
But I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line. In pregame, get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
Second down and inches. Escaping the pressure right. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
set up a throw. Guys, man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown. A great play there. His fifth touchdown now. To get this run game going better.
Sometimes you just have to credit the defense. They came in with a plan themselves. So I think now you try to mix things up a little bit. Get the ball in the hands of some other people. Find some other playmakers. But always let the defense believe that he's still a threat.
Don't forget about it.
No, don't take him to the end of the game.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. First and 10, Watson looking deep downfield. And this one is incomplete.
So I'm talking about.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Throwing again is Watson. He completes it to Stewart.
Bro.
He's got this to the 30 before being taken down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to make completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
First and 10 here. You know, if they could just get three out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost. Again, it's Watson.
That's what I'm talking about.
Second of their timeouts. As the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. Throw again on second down. Watson.
The tight end is certainly positioned built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then of course they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play. And that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Here's Watson.
Damn. Fuck yeah.
The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done? Well, that is certainly not complimentary football that we saw right there. The defense is supposed to help their offense, not give up another touchdown.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. We'll get back to you and Charles in a minute. But first, time to give the folks at home a look at what's going on around the NFL. We'll begin up at U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis, where it was definitely a game with some intrigue. By the scoreline, the Vikings able to avoid an 0-4 start as they pick up that critical first victory of the year. From there, we're off to check out another game, and they were losers in that one to the visiting LA Chargers. Justin Herbert sharp in the victory as his guys bounce back from a tough start to the year to play victory number one. Finally, let's get right to the center of the U.S. map and check in on the Chiefs at home in Kansas City. And they were winners in that one as they take care of the visiting Denver Broncos. Patrick Mahomes, 2 touchdown passes as his guys remain unbeaten. Meanwhile, in our game, no shortage of offense as each team has been able to move the ball effectively. Will the defenses show up in the second half? Find out. We give it back to our commentators, Brandon Gotten and Charles Davis. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. So time for the second half as the Steelers have the lead. so be receiving the football here to start the third quarter. Take it in at the three. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. Just shy of the 40 to mark it down at the 39. 52 yards rushing now on 8 carries for him so far. They've got the lead early here in the third quarter, and runs like that are how they establish that lead in the first half.
I love the fact that you're using the word lead, because they're leading from the front, pounding on the defense right now with the running game, and truly establishing themselves here in the second half.
They'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
On second down, this is Harris. He stopped immediately.
Okay.
Continued here in the third quarter. Another big play right there.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Now back to throw. He's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's a perfect word for it, precise, because if you're at 70% or better,
bitch. No way. No. No way. No way. Let's see.
Potentially a big turnaround brewing to begin this third quarter as this defense forces a much needed turnover.
He's down. He's down, bro. No challenge, of course. Thank you. Thank you, motherfucker.
And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
Well, that's unfortunate. Guess I'll take the points.
Now a field goal forthcoming for the Steelers. From the right hash here should be an easy one. And his kick here is good. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
It's a secondary, they really look close.
Yeah, we
and that was amazing
exactly.
Because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
First down throw, Watson. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Hey, let's face it, you can put any Halloween costume on, you're not going to be able to disguise him, because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up on his right, tried to work his way back to his left, but just a minimal gain as the defense is able to get it quickly.
With that grab, he now sits at 200 for his career, and maybe more importantly, a first down. And off comes to Chubb. And down inside the 35, he goes to the 32-yard line. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and 2. Back to throw, Watson. And to shove it here, complete to his tight end.
The offense reads blitz. Doesn't matter where it's coming from. Tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. Route, so to speak.
On first down, Watson. They've
given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
To throw again on second down. Watson drops it off for Chubb. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for offense.
Damn. Damn, damn, damn.
Secured the catch and setting up first and goal.
They'll run with Chubb.
Ah, the fuck was that? 160th career rushing touchdown.
His second touchdown of the game, his 3rd on the year. And the Browns have cut it back within a score. So it was the passing game that got him down here. The closer to the goal line, it's the run game that gets him home.
Certainly appears to look like the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there going to the running game to get him over the goal line.
As they begin this drive, 1st and 10. They'll start the drive with Harris. And he'll manage to pick up about 4 at 2nd down.
It's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
And he'll get this only up to about the 35. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other 3 here on 3rd down? Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And he's going to have the 1st down as he's brought down at the 44-yard
line. Damn.
Looks like he's going to get a couple here on this 1st down carry, and that'll make it 2nd and 8.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground, but I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Check. yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage. Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense gets a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. He gets it forward for four, maybe five, but the flags fly. And this one could be coming back. That time, the right guard sending him backwards.
And so many different types of guys rotate in on the defensive line now, depending on situations. You can get the bulky guy, the fast guy. No matter what, though, you can't hold him.
Final minute now of the third quarter. They'll drop the throw. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch, dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number four in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. It doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the secondary, figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
Flush to his right. That is caught at the seven. And in for the Steelers touchdown from 19 yards away. And the Steelers find a way. Feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
And he's
going
to be dropped following a pickup of seven past the 30 to the 32. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. Off play action, Watson, and this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
So much about defending the pass is being able to be right there at the moment the ball gets to the receiver, and he was right in his hip pocket, helping force that incompletion.
Watson on third down. That's a short one here, complete to the tight end. The Browns with a deficit. They're trailing, but with the football here to start the fourth. To the air yet again. Watson. Good throw here. That's complete. And he'll be taken down about before he gets into enemy territory.
Now, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple scores. They've really got to get some yards in chunks, and they know the defense doesn't want to give those up, but they've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? The kicker here is complete. That's good for a pickup of 10 yards, and that'll make it second and a foot or so. And on that last play there, he's over 400 yards passing now.
You know what that generally means?
Success.
That, and it means you really didn't miss opportunities. Usually very accurate. The ball's getting to the right place. Guys are making yardage after the catch to help you out that way. I mean, the whole team has picked it up. And don't forget, that means the offensive line has had a pass protect pretty well, too.
Everyone dialed in. Down, it's Watson. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
Anytime the ball's thrown in the middle of the field and it's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch, no matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
To throw once more on second and 10. Watson over the middle, complete. It's Stewart. 9 yards, not quite enough. He'll be left now with third and one. But it might go to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball.
going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score, because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down. Chubb again. He's into the end zone. Touchdown. Chubb taking it in for 2 yards.
The ball game and kept the pressure off of their own offense.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
Well, listen, when you've got the lead, there's absolutely no sense trying to pin a ball in where you shouldn't. You see the coaching in his head taking place on that play, because he saw he had a receiver in the area and just put it well over his head out of harm's way.
And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back, because you're praying to old momentum. He's wondering if he should change.
And look at this. They get the tackle, and he gets intercepted.
Motherfucker.
So, yes, something we didn't see a bit from this offense in the victory last week. That's a turnover. They didn't have any, but giving the ball away here in the opening quarter.
I love the surprise in your voice, because it's exactly what you stated. Didn't see it last week, but it's a key to their win. And it'll be a key to this game as well. Protecting the football. Didn't get it done there.
And the completion results there in 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. Out of the gun, Watson. Fired quickly here, and that's complete. And the Browns are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6 yard line. A looming decision to make on the conversion, down 7. But first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. From the gun, here's Watson. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about that? The boy there on first down got his hand in and knocked it away.
Second and goal. Watson. And put through here. That's complete. And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3. And they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can. But this is third and goal. They'll give it to Chubb. And he's in. Touchdown. And it was his interception on the last drive that wound up leading to a game-tying touchdown.
And somehow, you can make this a positive thing. You know why? Game tied now, so you're not protecting a lead, so you're not playing that way. You got to go get the lead again, so maybe it loosens him up a little bit and allows him to go ahead and be a little more free in his play.
And again, this time the tailback, and not much, maybe a yard up to the 29.
Now that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick, more than a space eater. He just made a great play there.
The Steelers on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This will be 3rd and 6. And that nearly intercepted. Going in for his hands defensively. That's a run he probably thinks he should have come up with. Instead, it's 4th down. And the punt team on now as this one sent away. Field tackling there, a 50-yard punt followed by just a 1-yard return. And the Browns will take over, 1st and 10. And here comes a big tight end as he gets set for this next drive. And we see here the productivity certainly has decreased from the start of the game, but sometimes people forget these tight ends, they can do more than just catch the football.
That is so true, because now when things start to happen and you're not getting the ball as much, maybe you change your focus on the game. Maybe you become a very good decoy. Maybe you block a little bit more. But sometimes you have such a great first half, you expect it to continue to roll, and it doesn't just happen that easily in the second.
And they have been able to shut him down, at least as of late. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it. So it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm gonna keep going.
And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. Fielded at the 33. They'll score that a 36-yard punt. And the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the fourth quarter. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. He'll get a nice jump there on the first down run, and it's second and four. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll take it down shy of 45 at the 46.
Make it happen! That's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And in that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Forward for about three at second down.
Well, praise has to go to the guys in the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
Now here's a throw. It's complete. This big game continues. Already has the three touchdown grabs, tacking on some more yardage in the first down.
How precise has his route running been in this game? We just saw him get open yet again. He's also made adjustments as the defense has tried to really stop him.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
So the Steelers with a football as we get you reset. They've got it first and 10 as they search for a go-ahead score. Now left side of the swing pass. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. He has been terrific today, hasn't he?
Yeah, absolutely. Run flawless 2-minute drill right here. This has been quarterbacking 101 with a flourish.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Flushed, and it's his caught touchdown. Wait, hold a second here. Flag down. Let's see if this will stand. And yes, they want the points to go. How will this thing pan out? We'll watch as they come up on first down. Watson to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. Through the sideline, and look at that catch, dragging the toys. That's going to be a first down. Throw left side complete. Ben Stewart. Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game. Second and 6. Now Watson. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. The Steelers now in the nickel here on third down. Here's Watson. It's a short one here. Completes his tight end. Browns will quickly use their third and final timeout as they get it with just 19 seconds left on the clock. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. He'll let this go for the end zone. And that is knocked away. And the ball in the field, but incomplete.
Someone took shooter in basketball, just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now, we had a guy who made the catch. They tried to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
There goes a deep ball. End zone. This is knocked away. Down and grounded incomplete. Now one more shot at it. Obviously, again, they've got to go for the end zone.
Well, we've seen it happen before. How about Aaron Rodgers throughout his career? He seems to pull it off about every other week. But if I'm the defense,
in a heavy traffic, and it's intercepted.
What a game, what a game. Man, what a game, man. That shit was wild.
It's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Pittsburgh, that early momentum continues here as they move to 4-0. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Buffalo to take on the Bills. Meanwhile, for Cleveland, they'll fall back to 500 at 2-2. And they'll be at home for one next week as the Baltimore Ravens come to town. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.